The second option for doing the captions is by using the manual button. The first thing to do in this option is also pasting the transcription, but now we are going to use the player buttons rather than the start and stop buttons on the open captions window. In the moment that the transcription is pasted, the first caption point is created automatically. This time, you have to play the video with the video buttons. You can see that the first three lines of the transcript are displayed under the video. When you hear that the text that is being displayed is over, pause the video and focus the cursor in the line where you want the new caption point to appear. Click on the manual button to make the new caption point and start the video again. You must hear now what you have written in the caption that is being displayed in the video. You must keep on doing this until the end of the video. We have two more buttons in the open captions window, and they are overlay and display. With them, we can select where do we want the captions to appear. But if we don't turn on the overlay button, the captions for default are going to be displayed under the video. If we turn it on, they are going to be displayed overlaying the video. The function of the display button is to give us a chance to decide if we want to produce the video with or without captions. If we leave the display button on, the video is going to be produced with captions, but if we turn it off, the video will be produced without them. When a caption is not well synchronized, it can be fixed by giving a right click on the blue dot of the caption point on the open captions window. Delete the caption point only. Focus the cursor on the previous caption point. Start playing the video with the player button and pause it where the new caption point has to appear. Click on the manual button to stamp it. Another way of fixing it is in the timeline. Zoom in as much as you can using the zoom tool. Play the video and pause it in the new point where you want the caption to start appearing. Look to the number that is displayed under the player and write it down. Select the caption point and drag it to the correct place. That is the number where the video was paused. As you can notice, the number changes along with the caption point. After finishing, click on the Finish button to go back to the Camtasia workspace. Everything's ready now to produce the video, and for doing it, I'm going to the task list, and under Produced, I'm going to click on the link Produce Video As. In the new dialog box that appears, go and click in the arrow to see the different options that Camtasia has for producing it. You don't have to have a great knowledge about video formats, because the options that Camtasia gives to its users to select from is where is the video going to be played, on an iPod, or does it want for the web or a blog, or maybe to save it on a CD. It has some other options that you can look at later. I'm going to produce it as a CD. Camtasia creates a folder with the same name that you give to the video. Here you can see the inside of the CD production. It has a single WMV file. Now I'm going to produce it as a web. When looking inside the folder, we can see that things are very different than when producing it as a CD. Rather than having just a single file, we have seven. Why is this? Because the video was produced as an embedded video. This means that the video and the player where the video is going to be seen are produced at the same time. From the seven files, five are for the player, one is a video that in this case is an MP4, and the last one is the HTML where the video and the player merge. These two different kinds of productions impact also in the kind of captions that we want to have. There are two different options, open and close. Open captions can be positioned under or overlay, and they are going to be displayed all the time in the video. Closed captions have always to be overlay, but the user has the options to turn them on or off by giving just one click in the CC button that is located on the bottom left-hand side of the player. If you have a little knowledge of video formats, you can go and select custom productions to customize your productions. Thanks for watching this video. I'm Marisol Miranda from EASY, Equal Access to Software and Information. And come visit us to http://easy.cc.